Hello everybody, this is Justin from KQS, and this is Nier Automata. So, I just wanted to run through the demo real quick. We're just gonna play it on normal. This is not about, like, being a cool guy or anything like that. We're just gonna play to enjoy it, so. This game is awesome, and I'll do a small breakdown, in a little bit, so as soon as I get control. I don't know why it just makes me laugh, all this like blah, this technological stuff. So my robot thing broke. That's what happened. I just crashed it.
Yes, I'm aware of that.
So this game, well, it's hack and slash. It's like Bayonetta, Metal Gear Rising, that kind of stuff. So hold on, let me. So you got your light, you got your heavies, you got your dash, and you have this little, that little robot thing that shoots for you. It's actually pretty cool because in this game, like I said, I like games that let you cancel things, like dash cancels exclusively, kind of like Hyrule Warriors. So you can cancel any move, and you can cancel that. So you can start just like, and then move forward. So dash canceling is the best thing. Just woo, 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 woo. Your dash is so cool because you can just, and that's the Bayonetta thing. If you hit the attack button right at the right time, you'll do that. You'll think of it like a little mini counter. But you can do lots of cool stuff with that. So, oh jeez, I am not dashing into the right way. Oh, let's rip that up. So L2 is lock on, and usually for these guys, I like to use the gun. So literally, I'm just holding down the gun and just attacking randomly. Not randomly, just like the gun is like covering me essentially. What's up, buddy? Oh well. Hiya! I think their letterboxing is pretty interesting. Cause like usually this would be black bars up top, but it's kind of like 50%. Well, I don't know how much percent opacity. So this is a pretty good demo because we get to fight bosses, and usually the best thing to do with these big guys is just shoot them all the time. Hey, buddy. That was close. Oh, gosh. And then dash cancel as soon as that hits. Because usually you have heavy recovery there. Oh. That's why I like this game. It's like it puts you on your toes. And now we have a new weapon. Jeez. Whoa. So this thing, L1, charges up your beam. But yeah, I'll give you a quick breakdown of everything, because you can do a lot of cool stuff in this game. I mean, this is just the demo. Yeah. And there's our new
sure
buddy.
He's actually dead next time. That was dangerous, man.
I really like their designs. It just looked really. It looks creepy with their eyes closed like
You're
that.
2B,
but
right?
I mean, they're all cyborgs and shit.
My
but
name's 9S.
It's just kind of. It's a little creepy, but it's kind of cool.
Copy that.
So, was that big old buzzsaw the Goliath you came here to take out?
Those, oh man, that buzzsaw thing. Just another. I think that's called an excavator. I don't know. They kind of scare me, honestly.
Well, I guess we have to find the target then, huh?
I don't know. They just like, cause those things. I mean, in real life, those things are huge.
I've got a flight unit, so I'll take a look around the perimeter.
Alrighty.
All right. I'll work my way inside from the ground.
All right. Come on. There we go. That was weird. But I don't know. Excavators scare me. Because, like, that'd be a horrible way to die. Just... Because, like, that shit's supposed to be designed to, like, break through the earth, essentially. But now we got little flying units. And what I usually like to do with these guys, is they're pretty annoying, is just shoot them out of the sky or use the L1 Mechawa shoe beam. So, there's some cool stuff you can do in this. So, I said light, heavy, you mix. I said that's light, heavy, and then you get this cool little ender. So, pretty much, heavies are your enders. But yeah, you can do normal combos with heavies, and it's still a pretty cool combo. But the brilliance of it is dash canceling. So we'll let her do her third attack, and as soon as it hits, bam, dash, dash, dash. So I mean, you can just, as I said, I'm just like, just dash canceling out of everything. And it's pretty fun. Also, if you hit up in the D-pad, you switch weapons. I think they're the same weapons, but they're, I guess having them in different, this becomes your light, and of course it's not a real light. It's a good one. It's okay, and then your triangle is this one, heavy. That's supposed to be the heavy, but it's not really, like it's an okay move. I prefer to use the standard. Because, like, I just feel like it... I feel like it's better. Like, I mean, This is generally for, It's generally for, close quarters. Slice, slice, slice. And it's cool, you can just start... You can literally start, like, you can just start, like, weapon swapping the whole time. So, I mean, usually doing high-level stuff, you just hold down the R1 button and just start shooting everything. But, that's pretty much the breakdown, and we'll jump into the main menu. So, the cool thing about this is you will have... Where is it? Skills. You literally have these plug-in chips, and the different plug-in chips give you different stuff. Like that one, the OS, if you completely remove that, that's the game over. It's kind of funny. It just resets you back to the main menu. But you can adjust your health, you can auto save points, objectives, you can adjust your HUD, you could literally have no HUD and just load this all with damage, which is kind of cool. And of course the auto item. So if I lose health, it'll as you can see, it'll auto heal, and I guess I get 15% more. But it's kind of cool. You really can't do anything in this mode in the demo. But I'm curious to see what you get to do. All right, I woke this guy up. But yeah, just that dash canceling is the best thing of this. It just feels so cool. And these guys, instead it literally becomes bullet hell for a second. Ah, shit. I killed him too early. Okay. Alright, I gotta not be too cocky on this one. Yeah, you generally collect materials. And you simply, eventually you'll probably be able to craft it into certain weapons and stuff. See, now we got our mini-map. because 9S was nice enough to give us the map again, or give us a map. And occasionally, these guys will pop in. Hey guys! I mean, she's very powerful. Oh yeah, see, there's one last thing. I forgot to show off. Hold on. So the cool thing about this, actually, I'll show it when the perspective changes. I think that'd be better because you guys can see it. Yeah, it's pretty good. She's got a double jump. She's got a lot of mobility options. I enjoy all her mobility. So I'll show it in here.
Exit confirmed closed.
So open it.
So you can so I'm holding, actually, hold on, let me give myself some space. But you can hold down heavy and charge up. No. That did not work the way I wanted it to. But you can charge up. Yeah. Do some cool attacks. But you can also charge up the light attack too. And it's more like a, she just kind of slides towards you. It's actually really cool looking. But what you can usually do, I like to use it as like a pursuit attack. So I like to dash forward. Like, I like to dash cancel as soon as the attack ends. Come on, let me shoot my gun, damn it. Come on! What? I can't shoot my gun. Oh well. That was weird. Cause, well, I mean, it's a demo, so I don't expect everything. We probably have a few little bugs happen from time to time. Oh jeez. See, now it's bullet hell. And now I'm doing really shitty. There we go. It's got a really good camera system too. Like, it just kind of, it's nice that it points you to where you need to go. It's actually a really good demo with good combat.
You know, ma'am, I'm glad you're here.
Why?
And then
scanners like me mostly
just
work
a bunch
alone.
Of cool items.
Scouting out enemy lines.
I mean, I don't know what they do yet. We'll get stuff as we go along. Like, I'm gonna get this game too. I don't know if I do a full playthrough, cause I don't know. RPGs are okay for playthroughs, but I feel like, hours of. I mean, there's nothing wrong with hours of playthrough, but it's like, oh man, this, like, sometimes with RPGs, I feel like it's like just a grind. I mean, nothing wrong with being a grind fest. I enjoy it sometimes. I enjoy grinding for levels. But I don't know how this I'll have to see how it really performs, like when the game comes out actually. But I hope people buy this, because this is really good. And I love how the camera, like, the perspective changes in some moments. Just let him shoot. And that's why I like to use my gun, because those guys are very, very stubborn. Like, you'll try to hit them and they'll just dash away from you. I'm like, damn it.
Repurpose the facility to increase their overall machine production.
So if we don't destroy it, they'll just keep coming.
Okay. Well, and the cool thing about the perspectives, because with your gun, if you can turn it into a twin stick shooter, just like whee. Usually the best thing to do is generally lock on. I think it's a very good thing to do.
Lock 43 to 12, return to
Yeah. I think this game will be pretty good. I do like the whole bullet hell thing.
It's just accessing random, nonsensical data from the old world. There's no actual meaning behind anything machines do.
Chakawashu beam! Okay, everybody's dead there. Let's just do this for a sec. Till he notices. Just cheese it out. Hey, buddy. Haha! And you got RPG stuff like leveling up. Hold on. Open this shit up. And this drops down. I said, this is actually kind of worthless because it drops down. That's where we were earlier. Because we went all through, all around, and they're just going in a big damn circle. So, this is progression over here to the left. Yeah, another good thing about the gun, like the gun blocks projectiles too. Because sometimes, oh, when you're in that bullet hell mode, it just can get really, really crazy. Screw you, buddy. There we go. Oh, one more. Didn't look like it. Nakawashu beam. Okay. Okay, I think we're good. But no, I hope this game does really good, because man, when I heard Scalebound was cancelled, I was really sad. Because I was looking forward to play it. I mean, I like Platinum games. I think Platinum is like one of my favorite Japanese developers. Like, they do a really good job on everything they do. I appreciate their, like, I don't know, I feel like, I mean, there's some good Japanese developers, but I feel like, I don't know, they know how to make a character feel good, especially games like this, like the hack and slash character action or whatever they call them. Like, she just moves so good, and I really like it.
I know.
Sometimes I wish it would lock onto the right person. And these guys also have shields, so it's bulletproof. Bring it on! Yeah! See, that's what the L1 is really good for, too. It's good for, like, ending stuff, too. Because usually it causes a knockdown. Man, more bullet hell. Because, yeah, if you did this without the gun, I think I would say you're crazy. Just do this. Okay. Didn't kill everybody. I was hoping it would. But yeah, I love her dash. I love her jumps. Like, because yeah, you have a side dash, back dash. Because R2 without pushing anything is back dash. And like, you can just dance around everybody. And I love that.
I surveyed the entire factory, but couldn't find anything resembling our target.
Maybe they, I don't know, moved it somewhere?
Is that?
You mean the bird?
Yeah.
There's more plants.
It's pretty crazy looking at the environment here. Everything's all gone to hell. All the vegetation and everything. Nature's taking it back. Aw. Oh, one cool thing I love about this is, like, if you hold the jump button, she has, like, a little hover. Well, not really, like, a hover. Like, she still just kind of just glides down, I guess. I wouldn't really call it a glide either, because it's pretty fast. Like, it's not like she can get, like, a little extra distance, but not, like, a lot. Yeah, get all the stuff. I've played this a few times. I think that the demo of it is just flat out really good. So I've been trying to play so when March hits I can just kinda jump into it. It's kinda like Metal Gear. When I play Metal Gear Solid 5, Phantom Pain. I played a buttload of Ground Zeroes. Like, I S-ranked all the normal missions, so I was like, okay, I understand how all of this works. She's got a sweet walk. Uh-oh. So we defeat one. Now we have to defeat two. And the music, oh, I love the music of this game. I need to get the soundtrack when it comes out. I don't think I can get the special edition from Square Enix anymore. Yeah, it's very simple. I mean, honestly, it's just dodge the big shit, and you have tons of mobility too. And that's what's nice about it, about these games, Platinum games. Because usually you're just a small person fighting the big everything. And yeah, it's really not that hard. I know, I make shit look easy, so. Uh-oh. And like, I mean, oh gosh. Okay. That freaked me out for a little bit, because I was like, okay, how are we going to dodge this? Because, like, the dodge is really cool, because you see, you kind of, like, teleport. But
target enemy detected.
If you get squished into a wall, it's not going to save you. Luckily, I got lucky there. So now, a cool turn of events. Hey, the big monster you're looking for was there all the time. Haha. And the crazy thing when you think about it is he literally is the level. He is level 1-1. So it's literally, I think it's really cool. So now more bullet hell. And the thing is, the only ones you have to dodge is the brightly colored red ones. But, yeah, just fight the level. Come on. Really? This is all you're gonna do this time? I'm surprised. Usually he's got more of a repertoire of shit to do. Okay, there we go. And the nice thing I like about this is you can lock on, or you can. Okay, we got missiles. Dodge the black spots. Nekawa shoe beam. Unfortunately, I can't do shit. Oh, that was easy. It's like, cool, now we got some backup. Got a Zone of the Ender's mech ship.
What's your status?
This is the target. I'm going to destroy it.
Right. I'll provide support.
The nice thing about all the robots, all the robot monsters, their eyes glow when they attack.
Incoming enemy attack from below.
Oh shit. Okay, get out of here. Yeah, this is, so now okay, now he's got a little bit more varied attacks. See, there's the good dash canceling right there. Canceling out of your animations. I don't know, I think that's like my favorite thing about certain games. Or these kinds of games, like... Well, not Dynasty Warriors. Dynasty Warriors doesn't have anything like that, but like... A lot of their spin-off games, like Gundam and One Piece. Oh, that's crap. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Oh, no. I don't know. I think this is, like, the coolest thing when, like, missiles literally just stand there. And then they switch back and shoot people. I think it's, like, one of the coolest things. That's why I like all the animes. Of all the cool action scenes.
Boost!
Oh, no.
Nine-ass!
Damn. I don't know why it looks like Metal Gear, like a strut from Metal Gear.
9S.
That's what it reminds 9S me of.
Black box signal detected. No response to communications.
I'm going after him.
And we gotta jump back on top of this dude. Get back on the level, essentially. It's kind of crazy. It kind of blows your mind when you think about it like that.
Request to command.
Negative. Communications have been jammed.
Come on. Oh, it's cool. I need to find a picture of the guy who made this. He it's funny. He just wears a mask from now on. It's like hilarious. Like he looks like a moon. He looks like the Majora's Mask angry moon, and it's funny. And it's just it was like three. Ever since they announced it, there's like been three occasions where I've just seen him as Mr. Moon. I wish I knew what his name actually was. Alright. But. But now he's a pretty cool guy.
I have to help 9S.
Okay. Gotta go help him now. With his messed up leg and everything.
Pod, get me staunching gel and logic virus vaccines, then access the-
Inadvisable. The subject's vital signs are too poor to attempt field repair.
Shut up! Just do what I say!
We'll get through this.
2B, just go.
You shut up too.
We're soldiers. We take pride in our service.
Cool.
HO-229 flight unit. Command 677 received. Usage rights transferred from 9S to 2B. Requesting acknowledgement.
So we got a mech now.
Please.
All right.
Rest easy, buddy. We'll get him for you. Yeah! Look at our sick mech. And you think... like, it's nuts, because you think 2B's mobility is nuts? Like, look at this shit! Choo-choo-choo-choo! So now, all we really have is the guns. It's not too bad, because the guns... Well, we do have a hit triangle, You get a nice little... I mean... Oh man, just the mobility of this is just too nuts. That's what I love about this level. And just dodge upwards.
It talks? I didn't know the machines had that kind of intelligence.
Yeah, it does a little bit of damage. Oh gosh. He's got his own mecha washu beam. I mean, look at that. In this little bit of time, we've just knocked off... Oh god. Most of his health.
To be the control of the enemy's upper arm, Yusha Pod should be able to.
Like he doesn't even stand a chance. I mean, he's big and powerful, but man, I have all these little hits that I'm doing is just eventually gonna count. And now this is where it gets cool. So now we're playing, like, afterburner stuff.
Seize the control system.
Affirmative. Infiltrating enemy subunit. Behavior table.
And
adjusted.
I think it's kind of interesting, because it's pretty much like Metal Gear Excelsis from Rising. I won't say any, I won't spoil anything, but that's what it's pretty much like. Oh gosh, that was scary. There we go. That's pretty much like Metal Gear Excelsis in this part. Well, this last moment. Yeah, we beat the level, literally. Yeah! Do cool anime things. He's still alive. Awesome. Yeah, Nines is pretty cool. Actually, both of them are pretty cool. It's just I do like 2B a lot. Her dress is really awesome.
Request assistance. No, it doesn't look like that's going to be necessary.
So we beat the level, and there's the next four levels to play. He's gonna try and kill us. This is gonna be fun.
I don't imagine that this is going to end well. The black box.
Yeah.
It's ready.
The Tesseract Cube.
Right.
So, actually, I will shut up.
Requesting destruction of enemy hostiles via black box reaction.
Request accepted.
Doobie, it was an honor to fight with you. Truly.
The honor was mine.
Yeah. And then there's like, you have that gif of Sarah Connor in Terminator 2. But yeah, that's the end of the demo. For how short and sweet it is, it's short, sweet, and like, There's a lot that they showed, and just there's a lot of depth to the combat, and I'm excited for it. But I'll let you guys go for now. I'm gonna probably start recording Resident Evil 7 now. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Just give me a thumbs up and subscribe for more reviews and randomness. I'll get a review soon. But again, thank you for watching. And again, this is Justin from KQS. And until we meet again, comrades.